Today we are going to start the next article, that is dielectric. First of all, we should know what is dielectric. Dielectric is purely an insulator. It is not a conductor. And you know that in insulator, the electrons are not free. That's why it is categorized in the category of insulators. And it does not conduct electricity. Then what is the role and use of dielectrics in capacitors? It only transfers the effect and it does not transfer the charge. So we can say the dielectrics are substances which directly do not allow the flow of charge through them, but they transfer the effect of charge due to polarization. Now, what is polarization? Dielectrics are categorized in two basic parts, that is polar dielectrics and non-polar dielectrics. In polar dielectrics, a small dipole moment exists in the molecule of the dielectric oriented in a random direction, and in non-polar dielectric, there is no internal dipole moment of the molecule. Some charges are generated on the faces of the dielectrics, which transfers the effect of electrostatic force. Now, first of all, we should know what are the polar and non-polar dielectrics. So, before that, if we summarize that, dielectric is a substance, which does not allow the flow of charge through it. It only permits and exerts the electrostatic force of attraction due to polarization of charge. So, dielectrics are basically of two types, that is polar and second, non-polar. And polar and non-polar are basically the molecules which are the part of that dielectric substance. Jaisa ki inka name suggest karta hai, polar means having poles and non-polar having no poles. Polar dielectrics are those substances in which center of positive charge do not coincide with center of negative charge, and there is a permanent intrinsic dipole moment of that molecule. These type of molecules are called polar molecules. For example, if we consider the polar molecules like HCl. HCl is basically a polar molecule. HCl, it is a polar molecule, and chlorine is a negatively charged and hydrogen is a positively charged. But the electron affinity of chlorine and hydrogen are different. That's why the center of positive charge will not coincide with the center of negative charge. And there will be a permanent dipole moment. So this can be considered like this. This is a negative charge, this is a positive charge. And an internal dipole moment P exists in the molecule. Suppose there are large number of molecules of this type in the dielectric, and all such molecules will not be oriented in a single direction. They will be oriented in random directions. And that's why if external electric field means there is no external electric field on the dielectric, then these dipoles are arranged in random order and net dipole moment of the substance is zero, because dipole moment P is a vector quantity. Or agar hum large number of randomly directed vectors lein, to unka resultant kya aayega? That is zero. So in fact, in absence of electric field, external electric field, the net dipole moment is zero, but in presence of electric field, a definite dipole moment generates. And that dipole moment is responsible for polarization of the charge on the face of the dielectric. Now, we will draw the diagram in both the cases, that is in presence of electric field and in absence of electric field. Now, if we consider two situations, one E is equal to 0 and second E is not equal to 0. E means external electric field. Now, if E is equal to 0, so we can have a dipole in the form like this. That is, it can be oriented in any direction. And dipole moment P is directed from negative charge distribution to the positive charge distribution. So we can see that all the dipoles are randomly oriented, and the net dipole moment in absence of the external electric field is zero. For example, iska dipole moment ka direction ye hoga, iske dipole moment ka direction ye hoga, इसके डायपोल मोमेंट का डायरेक्शन ये होगा और इसके डायपोल मोमेंट का डायरेक्शन ये होगा. अब आप देख सकते हैं कि सबके अलग अलग डायरेक्शन, एंड डायपोल मोमेंट पी इज ए वेक्टर क्वांटिटी डायरेक्टेड फ्रॉम नेगेटिव चार्ज डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन टू पॉजिटिव चार्ज डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. जब हमने एक्सटर्नल फील्ड लगाया, यानी इनको अगर वेक्टर एडिशन किया, तो दैट इज वेक्टर सम ऑफ ऑल द डायपोल मोमेंट्स रिड्यूस्ड टू जीरो, because they are randomly oriented. Now, in case when there is external electric field, then we can say, for example, electric field is directed in this direction, so this becomes a negative charge, this becomes positive charge, this is negative, this is positive, 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 and so on. You have studied one article in dipole moment, that is electric dipole, that a dipole is in a stable equilibrium when external electric field and dipole moment P are in the same direction. You can see here that all the dipoles have aligned themselves in the direction of external electric field. And if all the dipole moments are aligned in same direction, then it means that if we find vector sum of all the dipole moments, then it will also be in the direction of the electric field. So a net dipole moment P is generated when an external electric field is applied on a dielectric of, that is, polar molecules. Yani jo molecules polar hain, agar us par hum external electric field apply karte hain, us condition mein ek net dipole moment generate hota hai, aur ek face pe positive charge generate hoga, dusre face pe negative charge generate hoga, and the charge generated on each of the faces of the dielectric is called polarized charge. And the cause of polarization of the charge is the presence of external electric field. That's why the charges have aligned themselves such that the dipoles, small dipoles formed, have their dipole moment parallel to the electric field. Or aap jante hain ki jab bhi dipole moment P aur electric field E dono parallel hote hain, in same direction mein hote hain, then that dipole is in stable equilibrium. Clear? So this was the example of a polar molecule. We have taken HCl molecule. Because अब देखिए HCl में क्या होगा, HCl, H is H plus hydrogen and this is chlorine. Electron affinity means electron loving capability of chlorine is much larger than hydrogen. That's why this electron is more often towards chlorine charge. So this is about the polar dielectrics. Now we should come to non-polar dielectrics. Jaisa inka word indicate karta hai non-polar, because they are not polar. Aur polar kab honge? Jab do poles generate honge. Non-polar kab honge? Jab do poles nahi generate honge. Dono poles kab nahi generate honge? The example for this is when center of positive charge of the molecule coincides with the center of negative charge of the molecule, then the dielectric formed is called a non-polar dielectric. And the internal dipole moment of the molecule is zero. Molecule, jab uske beech mein koi separation hi nahi raha, to dipole moment zero ho gaya, because P is equal to Q into D. If D tends to zero, then what happens? P tends to zero. So center of positive charge or center of negative charge coincides karte. Now we can have the example of non-polar molecules like H2 and CO2. There are two oxygen molecules, that is CO, Now, we have simply represented the orientation of oxygen, not with the single or double bond. Now, we know that this bond is double bond and this bond is double bond, because valency of carbon is 4 and 2 electrons have been shared from oxygen each to complete the octet. But now I am not a chemistry teacher. We only know that since the electrons which are being shared from the carbon atom are equally dragged by the oxygen molecules on both the sides, that's why we can say that center of positive charge, center of mass of positive charge coincides with the center of mass of negative charge, and the net internal dipole moment is zero. So these molecules are called non-polar molecules. And these non-polar molecules, when constitutes and form a substance, that is called a non-polar dielectric, because it is basically insulator. And dielectrics are insulator. Now, come to the behavior in external and that is in external electric field. When the external electric field is zero and when it is not equal to zero. Now we know that if we draw E is equal to 0, means external field is 0, and here E is not equal to 0. So for E is equal to 0, we can draw like this, that is minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, means center of mass of positive charge is not coinciding with, is coinciding with the center of mass of negative charge, and net dipole moment of a particular molecule is zero. These spheres are symmetrical in shape. Basically, these are represented in the form of circles. Symmetrical, they are purely circles. Circle का मतलब क्या हुआ? कोई भी deformation नहीं है. हमारे drawing में थोड़ा error हो सकता है, but these are circles. Now, when external electric field is applied, you know that positive charge has tendency to drift in the direction of the field, and negative charge has tendency to drift opposite to the direction of field. तो इसमें क्या होगा? पॉजिटिव चार्ज इधर को ड्रिफ्ट करेगा. जैसे एक मैं यहां एग्जांपल ले लेता हूं, फॉर दिस इट इज पॉजिटिव चार्ज, दिस इज नेगेटिव चार्ज. नाउ दिस चार्ज हैज टेंडेंसी टू ड्रिफ्ट इन दिस डायरेक्शन एंड नेगेटिव चार्ज हैज टेंडेंसी टू ड्रिफ्ट इन दिस डायरेक्शन बिकॉज एन एक्सटर्नल इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज दिस. यू नो दैट पॉजिटिव चार्ज एक्सपीरियंसेस फोर्स इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द फील्ड एंड नेगेटिव चार्ज एक्सपीरियंसेस फोर्स opposite to the direction of electric field. So it will move, it will have tendency to move in this direction, and this negative charge will have tendency to move in this direction. Now what happens? We know that these are turned into small dipoles of definite dipole moment. और फिर वही रिजल्ट आ गया. अब देखा कि पॉजिटिव इधर को ड्रिफ्ट हुआ, नेगेटिव इधर को ड्रिफ्ट हुआ, एक डाइपोल फॉर्म कर लिया इन्होंने. अब जब एक डाइपोल फॉर्म कर लिया तो क्या हुआ? सारे डाइपोल मोमेंट्स, सारे जो डाइपोल्स फॉर्म हुए उनके डाइपोल मोमेंट के डायरेक्शन क्या है? यही डायरेक्शन पी. अब क्या हुआ? अब इनका भी एक नेट डाइपोल मोमेंट हो गया. तो इससे ये क्लियर हुआ कि वेदर द डाइलेक्ट्रिक पोलर और नॉन पोलर एंड द रैंडमाइजेशन ऑफ स्मॉल डाइपोल्स फॉर्म्ड इज इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एंड नेट डाइपोल मोमेंट पी इज जनरेटेड इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ electric field. So now we can see this, that in both the cases, that is in the case of polar and non-polar dielectrics, a dipole moment P is generated and there is a net dipole moment P in the direction of applied external electric field. This process is called polarization of the dielectric. Polarization of the dielectric, and the extent to which this dielectric would be polarized depends on the potential energy of these small electric dipoles. Now we come to the term that is polarization density P. Now for representing the level or extent of the polarization, we represent a term that is called polarization density P or electric polarization, and it is a vector quantity. The direction of polarization is in the direction of अप्लाइड एक्सटर्नल इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. क्योंकि आपने देखा कि जो भी पोलराइजेशन हुआ और नेट डाइपोल मोमेंट जनरेट हुआ वो एक्सटर्नल इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड की डायरेक्शन में जनरेट हुआ. एंड पोलराइजेशन पी इज डिफाइंड एज डाइपोल मोमेंट पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम ऑफ द डाइलेक्ट्रिक. डाइपोल मोमेंट पी पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम of the dielectric. Now if we consider QP into D upon volume of the dielectric, where QP is polarized charge, where QP is polarized charge on the face of the dielectric, and D is the separation between the two faces of the dielectric. This can be made clear by drawing the diagram of dielectric when placed between the parallel plate capacitor, and we will draw it in this session only. But this is polarized charge. A polarized charge hoga D kya hai? For example, I am just making a simple diagram. Ye plates of the capacitor hai, ye dielectric hai, ye separation D ho gaya, aur इस पर जो चार्ज जनरेट हुआ ये माइनस क्यूपी यहां जनरेट हुआ और प्लस क्यूपी यहां जनरेट हुआ, वो एक्सप्लेन करेंगे क्यों ऐसा हुआ। अभी आप ये जान लीजिए, दिस इज माइनस क्यूपी, दिस इज प्लस क्यूपी, पोलराइज्ड चार्ज। तो क्यूपी क्या हुआ? पोलराइज्ड चार्ज। वॉल्यूम को क्या लिख सकते हैं? वी कैन राइट वॉल्यूम एज क्यूपी इंटू डी अपॉन ए इंटू डी, QP into D is it upon A into D, area of cross section, that is area of the plates into distance, A gives the whole volume of the plates of the capacitor. Now, we know that this D is common and you can write QP by A, and this exactly represents sigma P. Means polarized surface charge density, sigma P. Polarized surface charge density. So, polarization density is equal to what? Sigma P. Now, let us discuss next article, that is behavior of a dielectric in external electric field. Behavior of dielectric in external electric field. Now, we draw, that is two plates of the capacitor along with a cell or potential difference V along with a key. Now, we have placed here a dielectric, and a region between the plates of the capacitor is completely filled with direct. This is V. Now, this is positive plate, this is negative plate of the capacitor. This complete is a dielectric. Now, whether it is a polar or non-polar dielectric, I have just explained that when external electric field will be applied, then these small dipoles will align themselves such that dipole moment P of the individual molecules of the dielectric will be parallel to the applied external electric field for the stable equilibrium. Okay, so this positive plate, this is external electric field E naught. We have considered E0. Now, E0 is the external electric field. Small dipoles will be formed inside the dielectric, and the dipole moment of the individual molecules will be such that it experiences a condition of stable equilibrium. That is, dipole moment P is in the direction of external electric field. Ab dekhiye, jo dipoles generate hue usme negative charge idhar, positive idhar, negative idhar, positive idhar, negative idhar, positive idhar, negative, 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 positive, so on. We can draw
this diagram according to the polarization of the molecules of the dielectric.
Okay. Now you can see that inside the dielectric, all the charges are having their neighboring charges as an opposite charge, because here positive is having negative charge, this positive is having negative charge. So what happens? These internal charges neutralize each other, and a situation is generated like this, that these charges neutralize each other. And here the surface charge density is sigma on the plates of the capacitor, and here the surface charge density is reduced to sigma p, means the dielectric is not fully polarized. अब देखिए इसका next diagram हम कैसे बना सकते हैं. ये हुआ, अब ये डायलैक्ट्रिक हुआ, ये पॉजिटिव चार्ज है, ये नेगेटिव चार्ज है, ये फेस नेगेटिवली चार्ज हो गया और ये फेस पॉजिटिवली चार्ज हो गया. अप्लाइड इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ई नॉट इस डायरेक्शन में.
कंपेयर विद दिस डायग्राम, प्लीज कंपेयर विद दिस डायग्राम, दैट इज इंटरनल चार्जेस इनसाइड द डायलैक्ट्रिक have neutralized themselves, and only the charges on the two surfaces of the dielectric are remaining. Now if here a positive charge region is generated and on this side a negative charge region is generated, then it means there is an electric field which exists inside the dielectric, and the dielectric direction of this field is from this surface to this surface, and this electric field is called EP, that is polarized electric field.
Okay, and the direction of this polarized electric field is opposite to the direction of the applied electric field. ऐसा क्यों हुआ? We can have the analysis from this diagram. The direction of this polarized electric field is opposite to the external electric field. So net electric field inside the dielectric will be the vector sum of the electric field, that is external electric field and polarized electric field. Now we can write the net electric field inside the dielectric as E is equal to E naught minus EP, because E naught is in this direction and EP is in this direction. So we can say that these two fields, अब देखिए कि जो polarized electric field है वो definitely इस external field से कम है, क्योंकि polarized charge इस plates of capacitor के charge से कम है, इसलिए ये electric field कम है. अब जो net electric field होगी E is in the direction of E naught, and external की direction में. क्यों? क्योंकि E naught is greater than EP, that's why net electric field will be in the direction of E naught. Now from here we defined the dielectric constant K, K is defined as
E naught by E.
K is defined as E naught by E,
where E naught is electric field, applied electric field, electric field in air.
अगर ये dielectric नहीं होता तो यहां पर कितनी electric field होती? E naught होती.
और अगर dielectric हो गया
यानी हमने place कर दिया तो electric field कितनी reduce हो गई? E.
Now we can write this expression as E naught by E naught minus Ep.
And ratio of the electric field in air to the electric field in dielectric is called dielectric constant K of the medium. Or we can also say that is relative permeability. Relative permeability of the medium. Dielectric constant has another term. It is called relative permeability of the medium.
So we can say that
dielectric constant K of the medium is the ratio of electric field in air to the electric field in dielectrics.
And we know that the dimension wise this expression is dimensionless and this K is a pure ratio. This K is pure ratio. So this was the concept of dielectric constant K and the concept of electric field inside the dielectric and outside the dielectric. So we have seen that there is a polarization of the charge. Once again I am going to review this thing. There is a polarization of charge in the dielectric. Positive ke face ke pass negative charge surface generate hota hai. Negative face ke पास पॉजिटिव चार्ज सरफेस जनरेट होता है और एक इंटरनल इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड प्रोड्यूस होती है. एक्सटर्नल इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड और जो इंटरनल इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड है दोनों एक दूसरे के अपोजिट होती हैं. नेट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इनसाइड द डायलेक्ट्रिक इज वेक्टर सम ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड दैट इज अप्लाइड इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एंड पोलराइज इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. सो What happened exactly? जो हमने basic definition of dielectric थी कि does not conduct charge. इसने charge को conduct नहीं किया but it has transferred the effect due to polarization of the charge. इस effect को इसने transfer कर दिया due to polarization. It has not conducted. अब ये condition सोचिए कि अगर यहां dielectric की जगह से प्योर कंडक्टर होता what would happen? Now see here. अगर यहां प्योर कंडक्टर होता
ये कई सारे रिजल्ट क्योंकि ये बुक्स में नहीं दिया है कई सारे रिजल्ट इससे मिल जाते हैं आपको.
यहां प्योर कंडक्टर है यहां पर जो चार्ज सिग्मा पी है प्लस सिग्मा है. यहां जो इंडक्शन होगा क्योंकि कंडक्टर में क्या होगा इलेक्ट्रॉन्स कैन मूव फ्रॉम वन पॉइंट टू अदर पॉइंट. तो यहां जो सरफेस चार्ज डेंसिटी होगी प्लस की यहां हो जाएगी माइनस की.
सेम डेंसिटी क्योंकि इंडक्शन में क्या होता है सेम चार्जेस आर इंड्यूस्ड ऑन अपोजिट सरफेस हैविंग अपोजिट नेचर यानी मैग्नीट्यूड सेम होता है साइन उनका अपोजिट होता है.
अब यहां आ गया ठीक है. अब जब यहां आ गया तो यहां जो पोलराइज इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड थी ईपी उसका डायरेक्शन अपोजिट हो गया इसके अंदर और ई नॉट इज इक्वल टू ईपी.
भाई जितना चार्ज था यहां पे सरफेस चार्ज डेंसिटी यहां थी उतना ही सरफेस चार्ज डेंसिटी यहां हो गई. तो क्या हो ई नॉट और ईपी का मैग्नीट्यूड सेम है.
अब यहां नेट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड क्या हो जाती है जीरो.
That's why we say that inside the conductor, net electric field is zero. अब इसके अंदर कोई electric field ही नहीं. तो ये केस तब होता है अगर यहां पर एक insulator के बजाय एक conductor होता ये pure conductor होता तब ये situation arise होती. और तभी क्या होता इसका कोई effect नहीं रह गया था तब सिंपली ये होता है इनके बीच के सेपरेशन होती है, दिस इज कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ टू कैपेसिटर्स इन सीरीज, दो कैपेसिटर सीरीज में कनेक्ट हो, क्लियर। नाउ वी शुड टेक नेक्स्ट आर्टिकल एज द पैरेलल प्लेट कैपेसिटर पार्शियली फिल्ड विद अ डाइलेक्ट्रिक। दिस इज ए इंपॉर्टेंट आर्टिकल from board point of view, that is parallel plate capacitor partially filled with dielectric. Partially filled with dielectric. Now let us draw the diagram. On the diagram, and you can see and like the diagram. What we have done till now, it is the consequence of that. We have taken a dielectric of thickness t. Is dielectric की thickness t है और इसकी area जो plates की capacitor है, capacitor की जो plates हैं, उसकी जो area है वो इसकी भी area है. अब देखिए. जब हमने इसको प्लेस किया इनसाइड द प्लेट्स ऑफ द कैपेसिटर तो क्या हुआ, पोलराइजेशन हुआ और पोलराइजेशन ये माइनस क्यू पी चार्ज इधर आया, प्लस क्यू पी चार्ज इधर आया, प्लस क्यू चार्ज ये है, माइनस क्यू चार्ज ये है। अब जो पोलराइजेशन हुआ उसकी वजह से जो फील्ड जनरेट हुई, पोलराइज फील्ड दैट इज अपोजिट टू द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड, और नेट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड क्या हुआ, सेम इज दैट इज इक्वल टू ई नॉट माइनस ई पी, दैट इज E is equal to E naught minus EP, where EP is net electric field. Now we can just break this combination into two parts. इस derivation को करने के लिए सबसे basic यही है कि इसको दो part में कर सकते हैं, एक वो region जो purely air का है और एक वो region जो प्योरली डायलेक्ट्रिक का है। एयर का रीजन कितना आ रहा है, अगर उसको थिकनेस वाइज हम देखें टी इसका है तो डी माइनस टी जो लेंथ है वो प्योरली एयर की है और टी लेंथ प्योरली डायलेक्ट्रिक की है, एंड दिस इज इन सीरीज, दोनों जो रीजंस हैं वो सीरीज में है। तो हम ये कह सकते हैं कि टोटल पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस ऑफ द सेल is equal to potential difference across air and potential difference across dielectric. So we can write that is V total V is equal to V air plus V dielectric. Yani dielectric के cross जो potential difference हो रहा और air के cross जो potential difference हो रहा दोनों का sum किसके equal है, cell के। अब V air, we have studied one relation that is E is equal to V by D or V is equal to E into D. ये के relation हमने electric field और electric potential difference में पढ़ा। We can write this क्योंकि air की thickness क्या है? V is equal to what? That is E naught into D minus T. क्योंकि air की thickness D minus T है। एयर में इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड क्या है, ई नॉट। सेकेंड रीजन प्लस अब ई इंटू टी, ई इंटू टी हमने लिखा, दिस इज रीजन वन, इक्वेशन वन, ई इंटू टी, ई इज द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इनसाइड द डायलेक्ट्रिक, और यू कैन से ई इज द नेट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इन साइड डाई इलेक्ट्रिक। अब इस ई को हम रिप्लेस कर सकते हैं, अब डायग्राम की जरूरत यही तक थी, वी कैन रब द डायग्राम। नाउ सी हियर,
we can write V is equal to E naught d minus t plus E naught by k into t. This is equation second. हमने इसको चेंज कर लिया क्योंकि k की डेफिनेशन हमने क्या लिखा था, बिकॉज k इज इक्वल टू E अपॉन E नॉट, सो वी कैन राइट सॉरी E नॉट बाय E, सो वी कैन राइट E एज E नॉट बाय k, जो हमने रिप्लेस कर दिया. क्लियर? नाउ दिस इज द रिलेशन व्हाट वी वेयर नीडिंग. And E naught can be written as what? E naught is equal to sigma upon epsilon naught, that is Q epsilon naught A. Sigma upon epsilon naught, and sigma can be written as Q by A, that is charge per unit area. Now, in second step, we can use the basic formula for the capacitance of a capacitor, that is C is equal to Q by V. And this V is what? This is the net potential difference. This is net potential difference. So we can write the value, that is Q upon E naught d minus t plus E naught by k into t. A to V ki value E. Now if you take E naught common and put the value of E naught as FQ upon epsilon naught A, we can write in second step, that is Q upon E naught in bracket D minus T plus T by K. And now put the value of E naught, that is C, we can write here. Now we can write this value as C is equal to Q upon epsilon naught A in bracket D minus T plus T by K. ये है जो हमने किया. अब Q cancels out, ये ऊपर चला जाएगा. We can have C is equal to epsilon naught A divided by D minus T plus T by K. This is the final result for the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor when it is partially filled with a dielectric of dielectric constant K. जब कोई भी कैपेसिटर प्लेट्स को टी थिकनेस के किसी डायलेक्ट्रिक से इंसर्ट किया गया तो उस कंडीशन में क्या होगा, ये उसका नेट कैपेसिटेंस का फॉर्मूला होगा. अब इसके डिफरेंट केसेस हम एनालाइज कर लेते हैं बाय राइटिंग द फॉर्मूला. जस्ट सी हियर, नाउ केस वन When T is equal to D, का मतलब क्या हुआ कि this capacitor plate is completely filled, यानी कि जो capacitor का plates हैं उनके बीच का whole of the region is filled with the dielectric. अब इस expression में T is equal to D आप कर दीजिए तो क्या हो गया, C is equal to epsilon naught A D minus D plus D by K. ये जीरो हो गए, ये K ऊपर चला गया. इसको हम यहां नाम दे देते हैं CK. CK इसलिए देते हैं कि इट इज फिल्ड विथ डायलेक्ट्रिक ऑफ डायलेक्ट्रिक कॉन्स्टेंट K,
and it is this filling is complete filling.
तो क्या हो गया k times epsilon not a by d. और ये किसके इक्वल है, this is ck. ये किसके इक्वल है, k times c not. और c not क्या है, कैपेसिटेंस इन एयर.
यानी कि अगर किसी कैपेसिटर प्लेट को हमने एक डायलेक्ट्रिक से कंप्लीटली फिल कर दिया जिसका डायलेक्ट्रिक कांस्टेंट के है, तो उसका कैपेसिटेंस के टाइम इंक्रीज हो जाता है.
जो यहां से क्लियर है, वेयर सी नॉट और सी जीरो इज द कैपेसिटेंस इन एयर,
जो हमने पहले ही लिखा था.
सी जो पहला प्रूफ था, सी इज इक्वल टू एप्सिलॉन नॉट ए बाई डी,
ये एयर में. अब के टाइम्स इसका इंक्रीज हो गया. जब के टाइम कैपेसिटेंस इंक्रीज हो गया तो और भी पैरामीटर्स हैं जो चेंज होंगे, वो उसको बाद में डिस्कस करेंगे. लेकिन अभी तो आप ये जान लीजिए कि व्हेन प्लेट्स ऑफ द कैपेसिटर आर कंप्लीटली फिल्ड विद द डाइलेक्ट्रिक, देन कैपेसिटेंस ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर कैपेसिटर इंक्रीजेस के टाइम्स इट्स वैल्यू इन एयर.
या सी k इज इक्वल टू k टाइम्स c एयर, हम ऐसे भी लिख सकते हैं.
Ck इज इक्वल टू k टाइम्स c एयर.
नाउ
सो दिस इज केस वन. नाउ लेट अस डिस्कस केस टू.
सी केस टू, when t is equal to 0
means there is no dielectric in the plates of the capacitor,
what happens? C is equal to epsilon not a d minus 0 plus 0 by k, this reduces to 0 and this reduces to d, that is epsilon not a by d.
और यही वो फॉर्मूला है जो हमने सबसे पहले निकाला था. And this is the capacitance of the capacitor without dielectric.
Capacitance of the capacitor without dielectric.
Now, if case 3 is that if this capacitor plate is filled with a metal, case 3, if it is with a metal of thickness t,
अगर बजाय हम इंसुलेटर के यानी डायलेक्ट्रिक के हम एक मेटल स्लैब डाल दिए, और मेटल का डायलेक्ट्रिक कांस्टेंट क्या होता है, इंफिनिटी.
मेटल का डायलेक्ट्रिक कांस्टेंट इनफाइनाइट होता है. ठीक, क्यों इनफाइनाइट होता है, अभी थोड़ी देर पहले हमने निकाला.
यहां मैं आपको बता दे रहा हूं, के इज इक्वल टू ई नॉट बाय ई,
और हमने ये भी आपको दिखाया कि इनसाइड ई, इनसाइड मेटल ई इज इक्वल टू जीरो,
यानी नेट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड जीरो हो
मेटल में.
तो क्या हो गया, E naught by zero, so K is equal to infinite for metals.
ठीक, अब तो यहां आ गए, ये हमने explain कर दिया क्यों infinite होता है, books में नहीं दिया है.
So ध्यान से देखिए, C is equal to epsilon naught A d minus T, ये तो वही रहेगा, plus T by infinite. And this term reduces to zero, so you can say epsilon not a d minus t.
अब इससे क्या हुआ कि आपका जो है इफेक्टिव थिकनेस बिटवीन द प्लेट c वो कम हो गई. पहले क्या थी, d थी, t का उन्होंने कंडक्टिंग स्लैब डाल दिया, तो यानी वो प्लेस एक्सक्लूड हो गया, यानी सेपरेशन कम हो गया, इफेक्टिव सेपरेशन, पहले डी ज्यादा था अब कम हो गया, तो क्या हुआ? नेट इफेक्ट क्या रहा कि कैपेसिटेंस एक, ये कैपेसिटर जो डी सेपरेशन का था, नाउ इट इज बिहेविंग लाइक ए कैपेसिटर ऑफ सेपरेशन डी माइनस टी। अब उसकी इफेक्टिव सेपरेशन बिटवीन द प्लेट्स कितनी रहेगी? डी माइनस टी रहेगी। तो जब सेपरेशन कम हो गया तो कैपेसिटेंस बढ़ गया। तो सीबीएसई में पूछा गया क्वेश्चन था कि व्हाट वुड हैपन टू द कैपेसिटेंस ऑफ द कैपेसिटर इफ ए कंडक्टिंग स्लैब ऑफ थिकनेस टी इज इंसर्टेड बिटवीन द प्लेट्स। तो आप यहां से आंसर कर सकते हैं, इफ ए कंडक्टिंग स्लैब ऑफ थिकनेस टी हैज बीन प्लेस्ड इन बिटवीन द प्लेट्स ऑफ द कैपेसिटर, then effective separation between the plates have decreased, so the capacitance has increased. So this was one of the cases, that is when, and this was the most technical case, this was the most technical case, and CBSE usually asks questions on this, and this question was asked therefore last year. So now we should come to case 4. Case 4, now if it is filled with n dielectrics of dielectric constant, or directly I am writing constants k1, k2, k3, so on kn, having thickness t1, t2, t3 and Tm, then effective capacitance can be written as epsilon naught A D minus T1 plus T2 plus up to Tn plus T1 by K1 plus T2 by K2 plus up to Tn upon Kn. This is general formula of the dielectric having n dielectrics of thickness T1, T2, and Tn, having dielectric constants K1, K2, Kn. So this is the equivalent formula for the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitors partially filled with dielectric under the different cases. And now this is all for this lecture, but my suggestion would be, please go through the concept of the dielectric and dielectric polarization, read from the book, and then you can have the clear picture, because topics which are theoretical you can understand that, but it will be in your brain if you read twice, thrice and many times. So please refer to the book and read dielectric. We have 2 to 3 topics remaining in this module, that is dielectric polarization we have done, we have electric susceptibility, relation between electric susceptibility and permeability. So these two are topics remaining here in this sub chapter, and we will do this in next lecture. Till then, stay tuned. Goodbye.